everybody, it's Cinnamon Cooney, the Art Sherpa. I'm so glad you guys came today. So if you're here for this painting and you're looking for the live, be sure and check the iCard because that's where it is, and we do different crazy stuff in the live events. But if you're here just for the direct lesson, this is where you want to be. Materials, information, links, and stuff that you need is in the description below. Always click the little more button and it'll pull that out, as well as we try to put a materials menu at the beginning of the lesson. Anything you need, ask questions, like, comment, subscribe, because it really helps us out. I'd love it if you grabbed your paint, your brushes, and came back and meet me at the easel right now. Let's go. Our materials are 16 by 20 canvas, and our paint colors are very simple today. They are titanium white, phthalo blue, in Mars Black. Now my studio is quite hot and dry, so I like to use acrylic glazing liquid by Golden. It keeps my paint wet a little bit longer and also allows me to do glazes. That means transparent little coats of paint, and that can help me quite a bit. I'm gonna start with a number 12 bright. You could use a number 10 bright, just your largest bright that you have in your collection. Brights have a nice square edge. And I'm going to be doing paint directionality. I'm going to be painting my brush strokes from the upper left corner to the lower right corner. The interesting thing that I'm going to do today, and I hope you find this interesting too, is I'm going to do what's called toning my black. So my Mars Black here, I'm going to take a little of my phthalo blue and add it in, and that creates a blue tint to the black. So when I bring it over to my white and it's creating this gray, there's a little bit of blue in that gray. So here I come in the upper left, and I'm pulling these brush strokes kind of diagonally. I actually want it much lighter than what I have here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a lot more white paint to my mix, add a little of my glazing, and just lighten this up. That can happen to you in painting, where you start out, you have too much of a powerful pigment on your brush, and all you've got to do to fix that is wipe off your brush a little bit. Don't rinse it out, because some of that pigment's good. It's yummy. It's good. It'll cover your canvas. And go ahead and brush this back in. So we're coming this way. This is the direction the rain is falling. We're going to do this throughout the whole canvas. I'm going to pick up a little more black, a lot more white, and keep doing this. I like putting in this first layer. It's very expressive. You can see that I'm just allowing the paint to be very streaky on the canvas. That's actually very helpful. I'm allowing the paint to be very streaky on the canvas. I don't want the sky to be too light either, because I've still got to put clouds in on this windy day. You know, while you're painting this in, I want you to think about something, which is that whatever else you've got going on in life, in the boundaries of this 16 by 20 canvas, you can have it any way you like it. Anything you imagine, anything you dream, anything that's meaningful to you can exist right here. And that's something I really like about painting, is the way that everything I think about, I can have on my canvas. And that helps me feel optimistic and hopeful. And it's important to feel hopeful in life. I think sometimes the way our lives can make it very hard to feel hopeful. I'm pulling a little blue paint out from my blue. You can see it's just on the tip of my bristles here. A little more black, but I don't want to get too much. Here's the white. You can see how that's in a little bead. And then I'm going to grab a little of my glazing medium. But again, you don't have to have that. That's a lot about the conditions where I'm painting being very dry and very hot. That's all that is. Just trying to make sure that these brush strokes are sort of parallel to each other. That's going to feel like rain. That's nice that it does. Graying up my... I don't worry about every single bit of paint I put on there being the exact same color mixture. What's nice sometimes is when everything isn't perfectly matched up. The sky doesn't perfectly match up all the way across the horizon. It has a lot of personality. I know where I live in Houston that there's a lot of personality in our sky, isn't there? We have some weather, and it comes in all the colors and shapes that weather and clouds can come into. So I have a lot of reference that I like to help inspire me. A little more blue over to this black. It's a lot of fun. Fun in the color. Try to be easy with yourself if you're very new to painting. Actually, be very easy with yourself if you're very experienced in painting. This is a space where you get to be kind to yourself and forgiving and not expect perfection or have to live up to anybody else's expectations. This is your canvas. I like this painting and the strong, strong wind. I like that a lot. Makes me happy. Because I think in everybody's life, we all get a lot of weather, don't we? Things aren't always perfect. But that doesn't mean they're not beautiful. A rainy day is as beautiful as a sunny day. Just make sure that those brush strokes are parallel. It's the wind driving down. And coat the whole canvas. Sometimes these canvases fight back a little bit. Don't think it's just you. It's not. A lot of people find that if they use a small... Oh, I got too much black. When I get too much black, I wipe my brush. If they just brush on a little water on the canvas before they start painting, that can help them. Any paint will work. Any acrylic paint will work. Don't let, you know, your worries about having the right materials stop you from enjoying your creativity. It's just fun to paint no matter what. Here we go. I like that. If you're enjoying this lesson and you'd like to see more and you'd like to be present for some of our live events, where we talk about a bunch more painting techniques and all the things we can do, be sure and hit the subscribe button and also that little gear so you can get notifications so YouTube will tell you when we're live. Really appreciate that. And I'd also love if you would tell me in the comments below if you really like rainy days or you prefer sunny days. What's your favorite kind of day? Let's keep painting. Now I'm going to get a large round brush. But any round brush will work, and you could even use a square one, but I'm going to use my beat up old round brush. This is a lot of fun for me, and I enjoy it, but I'll give you an example of another brush that might work, like an old beat up angle brush could work as well. You just want a nice bigger round brush, and I'm going to get my just white out right here and grab my glazing medium. And I'm going to start adding some interesting clouds in my rainy sky. I'm going to come up in the upper right. And I'm going to just go up and down. What I think about clouds is very nice. is that they have really irregular shapes. And how I like to get my clouds is I put the brush in the canvas just on the edge here. Go up and down. This is my favorite cloud brush. Sometimes artists have favorite cloud brushes. But if you're really new to painting, just a large, round, stiff brush. What I mean by that is like it wouldn't feel good to put makeup on with. I'm just brushing this little cloud black and blending it a little bit. Coming, see the little circular motions I'm making to say this is a little puffy little cloud, and then coming across here, a little up and down. I'm always breaking up the pattern. That's what I'm always trying to do, is break up the pattern. I don't want a lot of water in this brush. I might use some more glazing medium. I don't want a lot of water in the brush, because that'll work against me. I'm gonna put some more friendly, funny little clouds up here. Pressure is super light. I'm just sort of dancing over the canvas, making little circles. You know, it's okay if it takes a while to get those cloud shapes. Get frustrated with yourself. You know, no one starts out an expert. Everybody starts out a beginner. You know, it's the joy of trying to paint clouds and practicing and experimenting and enjoying that practice. Just try to make sure that your clouds wander up and down and that they're not made of perfectly even shapes. Clouds are unruly. They don't listen. They just do what they want to do. Add a little one down here over on the right. You can see what's nice is that I put a little glaze into my white. So it's a little bit transparent. And it's blending into the background, which is great. That's nice because the blending medium has kept my paint a little wet for me. You can just sort of, you'll notice that I like to go back and forth, kind of level out the bottom of my clouds. Think about it when you're in your car next or you're someplace. Don't you look at the clouds up in the sky and think, how would I paint that? How would I do that? I think that's always so much fun, is to stop and look and think, how would I paint that? How would I do that? I like that part. Just think about being level. Nice little, you know? This is one of those sort of drizzle days, you know, when the rain is coming down, but it's not hard yet. It's not cold and wet enough yet to drive all the kids inside. They're still outside enjoying the last days of summer. Still playing. Do you ever stay outside until it asks you to come inside? Sometimes I do. It's nice. Just enjoying that. Because this, when I go back and forth like this and you hear that dry, scrumbly noise, that's actually what the brush stroke is called. It's called scrumbling. Isn't that fun? I like the noises that my paint makes when I'm painting. Let's go back and forth. Round and round and round. This is a distant cloud. It's very light. Barely shows up. That's okay. Maybe put some here. Kind of break up the patterns. Oh, it's distant, light, and far away. Oh, I really like that. That is a lovely, as Winnie the Pooh would say, it's a blustery day. Blustery days can feel wonderful. And I think this one does. All right. Now, I'm gonna dry my canvas with my hair dryer. Remember to keep your hair dryer 6 inches away from the canvas and move it around a lot. Sometimes when you're painting with little bottle paints, they can darken up. That's called color shift. When they're drying, and heat can make that even a little bit more noticeable. So try not to be too aggressive with your hair dryer, but it's still fine to use it. And it's a great fast way to dry your painting. I always enjoy it. I can tell that my painting's dry because it's no longer shiny. and also it's dry to the touch. But if you see little shiny areas, that means the paint is still wet and you may need to dry it further or wait for the paint to dry. I am going to put my landscape in. I'm going to use a number 10 bright. If you just had one bright, you could use that brush the whole way through, so never ever worry about that. I'm going to get my brush a little bit damp, but not wet. I want most of the water off of it. I'm going to put out some more of my liquid, because again, in my studio, it's very dry and it's very hot, and that does speed up how fast my paint can dry for me. I'm going to make a little landscape here. This is sort of an abstract, and this goes right across the canvas. It's really fun. So I'm going to come up about 4 inches from the bottom with just blue. Isn't that interesting? And kind of wander up and down. I don't want to make just a straight line, because that's not really how landscape is. I'm going to pull out some of my blue paint, and then I'm going to just paint this down like this. And I'm going to let the brush stroke have this very rough edge. You see how that is a rough edge? That's important to this piece. Sometimes we paint things exactly as we see them, and sometimes we paint how we feel them. And I think that's when art can be really healing, is when we paint what we're feeling, not necessarily what we're seeing. I'm just pulling that down and letting the rough edges of the brush taper off. I'm not taking it all the way to the bottom. I'm letting a lot of this still show. Just keep pulling it down and letting it have that nice tapered edge. It's okay that the paint is showing through underneath. We're just pulling it down as vertically as we can. That's all we're doing. Pulling it down as vertically as we can. Just nice and vertical. Paint this through. That's nice, isn't it? Not easy. Art is easy. Just gotta learn all the little tricks, all the little skills. Then you can paint too. And it's fun to learn them. I like the way that the landscape bleeds away. Pulling that down. Make sure that edge is really uneven. I think that looks nice, and I'm going to grab even a smaller brush, something that gives me a lot of control. This is a number 4 bright, so it's got that nice square edge I can use. Gives me a lot of control, and I'm going to put in my tree. This is a really fun part. So I'm going to come just a little bit. I don't want to be right in the center of the canvas, because if I'm right in the center of the canvas, it'll make it maybe a little bit calmer than I want it. And I want there to be a little drama on my canvas. Drama on my canvas, no drama in my life. I'm going to make an upward line like that. That's about 4 inches long. And I'm going to come just about a quarter of an inch over. Maybe almost half an inch. I'm going to make another little upward little line. Tapers together. See how it's thicker at the bottom? It gets thinner as it grows up. And that's what trees are like. So now that I have this funny little stick coming up out of the ground, I'm going to put in my tree. I'm going to come up my canvas. I would say this is about 4 or 5, more than a hand with my little thumb out, up here. And I'm going to start putting in my tree. And this isn't that dissimilar to what I was doing with my clouds. I'm making little circles, back and forth, you know, in that. Now, one of the things, if you're worried that you're going to keep the shape, a trick that you can do, don't make it too big, but if you want to make sure your tree has body and width, you could make sure that you put a little triangle underneath. So I know it has to be at least that big. This is a maple. We don't have a lot of maples where I live, but we have a few. So using that, I know I've got to be at least bigger than that. And I want to kind of hold that shape. The tree needs to be wider at the bottom, skinnier at the top. I'm going to take my little circles and make a very kind of uneven, happy little tree. This is a good tree. This tree lives out here. It's planted by a family. And it likes being where it is. It's grown here a long time. It's listened to a lot of kids play. And it enjoys its little tree life. See how very rough and uneven my little tree edge is there? That's what you're looking for. And the first layer really is black. And I'm going to come and make sure that this is not got a flat bottom, because the tree wouldn't be like that. This reminds me a little bit of the lollipop style trees that we do in grade school, but just a little more complicated. And who knew that that kind of tree could actually help you do this kind of tree later in life? I tend to like to get it asymmetrical and off shape. I'm coming around little circles, up, there I go up, but I'm gonna come back in because I don't wanna have too even of shape. Even though this tree is gonna feel a little bit like it's triangle, it also needs to still feel like a tree. That's an important part of this. Try to look and make sure you're not cloning or repeating the same ins and outs like this. That wouldn't look very tree-like. You want to be random, unpredictable. You know, be like to the people in your life. They don't know you. Maybe you do paint. They don't know. Maybe you don't know. Be optimistic about yourself and the things that you can do. You never know what you can do when you try. This is fun, and I enjoy it. Nice big tree. The size of the tree is really going to be determined by the girl and the dog, which is kind of interesting. How big those are tell us how big everything else is. I'm just doing these little circular. Isn't that fun? Just little circular, scrumbly little odd brush strokes. Just have fun. Just have some fun. It's okay if some of the canvas is showing through on your tree. You've got a couple more layers that you're going to be adding to that. And so I'm going to get my small bright out again that I did my blue with. This is the number 10. I'm going to go back and finish the next layer of my landscape. Hey everybody, be sure and give us a thumbs up. That really helps the channel. And tell us what you think of these lessons, what you're enjoying, what you'd like to see in the future, the kind of stuff you'd like to paint in the comments below. That's what I use it for, is just to get information about what you like, what's happening in your lives, or thoughts that you have about stuff that we're saying or doing on the show. Let's keep painting. So I'm going to pull up my black paint, loading it on just the tip, just this part of my bristles. I'm going to come back along my landscape line with this black. Painting over all the blue. I don't want any of the blue to peek out the top. It can peek out the bottom, but not the top. And I'm just painting the hill line in. Now I'm going to go ahead and again, on the edge of my bristles, I'm going to pull down a little bit of black. But I'm not going to paint out all the blue. I'm not going to paint out all the blue. Isn't this nice? Now already you have a nice landscape with some lovely clouds. It's fun. Just something different to do. All right. I haven't taken out all the blue, but I've layered some black on top of that. Now I'm going to paint in, while that's drying, my small girl. Something I want you to think about the girl is that she's leaning into the wind. Do you ever have to do that in life? Do you ever have to lean into the wind? Sometimes life feels like that. But she's just letting go and she's leaning in to this blustery day. She's not a realistic figure. I'm not trying to make her look highly realistic. I'm trying to be very decorative with her. So I've got a number two bright, and I'm also going to use a very small detail round to paint her in. The first part is I'm going to put in maybe her head. And she's not quite as tall as the tree. Just a little tiny small head. This is bigger than a pea. Just the circle. If you feel you've gotten her too close to the tree, or you've made a mistake, let me show you how you can fix that. You ready? All I've got to do is go back with my blue, my black, a little bit of white, and just come paint right over it. In the same way I painted the sky in. Everything in acrylic has a redo button, and it's one of the reasons I like the media. So if ever you feel like you've made a mistake, it's no trouble. It happens to all of us. You can just fix it. I'm going to try again. I want her a little further away from the tree, so I have room for my balloon. So maybe I'm going to put her on this hill I've made here. And that seems fun. Just paint her in. Just first start with a nice little circle. You can see how big the circle is in relationship to my thumb. It's not that hard. I'm going to use my detail brush so I have more control. I'm going to create the width of her body. This is very abstract. And honestly, you could paint anyone you want to into this painting. So her body comes out from where her head is. And then, before I put in the skirt, I'm going to do two very interesting lines. I'm going to do a little curve line right here, and another little curve line right here. How I get a fine line, like I do, is I'm using a very small brush with a good point and tip. I've added a little water to my paint to thin it so it flows off easily. And when I need the line to get smaller, I lift the pressure off the brush. Don't worry about getting this the first time you ever try it. It's something that takes practice. I'm trying to show that the weight of her body is into the wind. And right here, I'm going to put another little circle. And hovering little arm coming out and up, holding her balloon. Just delicate, small lines. Maybe she's got another arm coming out for counterbalance and comes out here. Little fingers trying to catch the air in her little hand. Sometimes in art, the less you do, the more our mind will fill it in. If you leave a little bit for the person, you, the viewer, your friends, your family, to think about, especially when things are slightly decorative or abstracted, their brain will do all the work for them. And you can just allow them to put their own story into here. Now, this could be a little boy. This could be a little girl. This could be you. This is your painting. And you're allowed to change it and make it your own. I'm gonna do a thin line coming back this way. This is the string for the balloon. It can be hard when the canvas is very rough. You may need to add more water to your paint like I'm doing now. Get just a little bit right on the edge there, on the very tip of it. Should take the little line up. Oh, there we go. That's a nice fine line. I'm resting my hand on the canvas. Just in this here, like she's holding. And do my little balloon shape, which is a bit like a teardrop. And I'll flare out where it's tied. Not easy. That's pretty nice. Now I'm gonna rinse my brush out a bit. Get some white paint. And just add a little hair to her head. Here's a little bangs. Little tiny little hairs. Any hairstyle you like. Just a little bit of hair. Make it long, make it short. It should probably be blowing in the wind a little bit. And I'm going to pick up some of my blue. Even though I haven't rinsed the white off my brush, I'm going to add a little blue to her dress. It's interesting how you can use just three colors and create a really fun painting. I'm going to paint in this balloon with the blue. It's just simple. It's just happy. It's hopeful. Maybe painting this will help you feel a little more hopeful in your life. I've just wiped off the excessive blue off my brush, and I'm picking up a little white right here. And I'm going to come and add a little highlight right up here in the corner of my balloon. Even though this is decorative, that little touch can be fun. And maybe some of these light blue highlights to her dress. Now one of my favorite parts, the dog. Get my black paint on my brush. And I'm going to come up. I don't want the dog to be much past her leg height. So I'm going to come closer to the tree. And I'm going to make a little bean shape. Just paint it in. Maybe your dog is tall, maybe your dog is short, maybe your dog is fat. That's up to you. I like to anchor him with a little bean shape. And I'm going to bring a little curve line here. And have his little head look back like that. Fun. Put some little ears up. He sees something, hears something. little back legs come to this little point. Make another little black leg that you can partially see. It's partially obscured, but still there. He's got a kind of wide stance. It's a little solid body. There's his front leg. There. And again, this could be any kind of dog that you have. It's okay for you to change this story and make it your own. And a little tail. And I'm gonna add some little fur coming off this tail and off the back leg a little bit by making these short dashing strokes. Isn't that easy? Super fun. Refine this how you need to. Remember, if you ever make a mistake, just dry it and paint over it. So now the dog is looking at something. We don't know what. The tree is here. She's leaning into the wind. Her balloon is blowing back. And let's create the highlights in my tree. I'm going to grab my number 4 bright again. And I'm going to get my blue, a little black, but mostly blue. And a smidge of white for this first layer. I'm going to tell some highlight stories in my tree. Yeah, same little circles. I'm not going to put them everywhere, though. That's going to be the trick. Kind of like my clouds. Don't put them everywhere. Just the tops. They're catching the light. Give this tree some shape. Some personality. Shape, little personality, little pop of color. Just 3 though in this painting. Isn't that interesting how just a few colors can do a lot? Just going around and around. Not the whole tree. If I put too much of this color in the tree would lose a lot of its personality, and I want this tree to have a lot of personality. A lot of different tones. I want to feel like I can hear these leaves blowing in the breeze, wherever this tree is. So happily planted. Just adding the blue, and you can see why. It's okay, because you were going to layer. Get a little black. You were going to layer. Inhale, layering. That's a little bit lighter than I wanted, and I'm going to come back with lighter blue in a minute. You can always just change your mind. If something gets on the canvas and it's not perfect, you don't just have to keep painting. You can go, wait, what? I might try it differently. There's no pass-fail in art. There's just, I'm making art. I'm happy with it. Or maybe I want to change it or experiment a little bit. Now that I have that blue in, I'm going to, without rinsing my brush, get a lot more white. Just add some more highlights, just here and there. Just some places to say the sun is catching the tree. You decide, where's the sun catching your tree? Imagine all the animals living in that tree. Where's the good warm branch? You get to be in charge where that good warm branch is. Nobody else gets to have an opinion but you. It's your tree. That's all. Just a little bit here and there. Not too much. And the last thing that I'm going to do, and I think this is my favorite part because it answers what our wonderful, faithful companion is staring at. I'm going to add some birds. And you've got to remember this from grade school. Remember how we used to do birds? This is really fun. And I still like it. We're going to do just the little flying V's. Just just little flying V's. Some of them need to be bigger. Some of them need to be smaller because their size says how far away they are. These birds are flying out. It's really far away. So if they're smaller and lighter, but if they're bigger, they're closer, aren't they? A little more detail to that one. Yeah. Just paint your birds. They're coming into this tree and the dog is noticing them coming in. Now, just go ahead and sign your painting. You don't have to. You know you're done. You did it. I hope you really enjoyed today's lesson. I hope you found it relaxing and made you think about the weather a little bit. How do you feel about it? What kind of weather do you like? I really appreciated spending the day with you, and I want to see you at the easel really soon. Bye-bye! Come join us live Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday at 11 a.m. Central, or enjoy one of the hundreds of paintings available on replay anytime.